In this section, we're going to learn about Triplanar and how to use it in a Unity shader graph. So first, what is Triplanar? It's a method of generating UVs and sampling a texture by projecting it into the world space. This way, we're not sampling the texture based on the game object itself. By the end of this section, you'll learn how to create an advanced triplanar that blends between two textures using the normal map direction, and it'll render perfectly no matter how the game object is rotated. This is perfect for quickly creating environments in any video game. So, I started with the Unity URP project, and then I imported these rocks from the Unity Asset Store and Sketchfab. I'll put the link in the description. I also have three textures, sand, grass, and snow, which we'll use for the secondary texture. Let's create a new lit shader graph. What we're trying to achieve here is to blend between two textures using Triplanar. First, let's create two texture 2D called main texture and normal texture, and we'll use sample texture 2D to render both of them. Make sure you select the type of the sample texture as normal. This way, we make sure that we're rendering our rock perfectly in the scene. Save it. Now let's apply our shader graph to our material. Here, we need to select the main texture and the normal map so that it appears again. Now, we have to add our secondary texture to render the second texture, and we'll lerp between them. Let's create the triplanar. We can start with the position node and use the absolute world space. Since we want to render the textures vertically, we want to access the y-axis, which is represented in the green channel. Using a smooth step node and connecting the y-axis to the input, we get a gradient between white and black, which means we'll lerp between the main texture towards the second texture using the y-axis. Here, we simply add another property to control where we want to render the second texture. We're going to subtract the 1 value to keep the blending ratio perfect, no matter where we want to blend. Then, we use the add node and we add 1 to the second texture, connecting it to edge 2. Once we select the grass texture, we now have a blend between two textures using the y-axis. So when the game object is above a specific point, we render the grass. But with this second texture height, we can change the blend point position. I've organized it here by grouping the nodes. We can convert the normal map to direction using the transform node, changing the transform from the tangent to world. We also change the type to be from position to direction. To access the normals that face up or toward the y-axis, we split this transform and we can access the green channel and multiply that with the smooth step node. Then we link the result to another smooth step node and then we connect the result to the lerp node. To control the amount of grass we want to be on the surface, we'll create another flow property, setting this to be a slider between 0 and 1. After dragging this property, we're going to use 1 minus to invert the values, linking the result to edge 2. Let's save and go back to the scene. We can see the grass has been rendered only on the face that's facing up. With this threshold, we can control the amount of grass or snow covering the rock at a specific height. No matter how we rotate the rock, we render snow or grass on its surface. Let's make this shader more realistic by adding the last feature. We are giving the same smoothness to rock, but the rock should have less smoothness than snow or other textures. So, to fix this, let's create two new floats, one for the main texture and another for the second smoothness. We'll use the lerp node again to blend between the main texture smoothness and the second texture smoothness using the same triplanar we just created. Hope you had fun following this tutorial. If you want to see more tutorials like this one, please share your thoughts and press the like button.